Sometimes waking up early on your day off is totally worth it. And I'm telling myself that today is gonna be one of those days. So I really love waking up early. I think it's because I have this natural energy most days that I don't need coffee, I don't need any sort of caffeine or energy booster. I can just wake up and be excited about the day and what's ahead of me.
Can I get a venti iced caramel macchiato?
Today is not one of those days of natural energy though. I can feel it coming in the air.
Hey, venti iced caramel macchiato?
Yeah, thanks man.
Have a good day.
You too. So, I think everyone needs to have like a spot they go to kind of clear their head, to put their thoughts down, to really kind of get stuff done and kind of step away from your normal routine, your normal room, your office, your desk. And so I've got my spot. It's right out here. It's this little dock. And I want to talk to you guys, put some stuff down to paper, and I want to get stuff done. So recently I've been reading in the book of Acts, and I'm really, really inspired by the work that God is doing through the disciples. They're performing all these miracles and just being used by the Holy Spirit for the work that God had for them. And I wanna be more like that. You see, when I read the Gospels and I look at the disciples, I almost see two different people. In the Gospels, there's a lot of lack of faith. There's a lot of lack of trusting in the Lord. And there's a lot of shortcomings and failures that we see from them. One of the places that always comes to my mind dealing with that is in Mark chapter 8, where Jesus feeds the 4,000. Just two chapters earlier, Jesus fed the 5,000. Yet in this moment, the disciples ask, Lord, how are you going to feed these people? They had a complete lack of faith, even though Jesus just did that miracle. And so often, I'm the exact same way. My lack of faith sometimes doesn't manifest itself as calling God out and saying, hey God, how are you going to do this? But a lot of times for myself, it manifests in me just having to do more. Working late, working extra days, working extra hours, because I have to get it done and I don't trust the Lord to do the work. And that's been the season I've been in lately. I look at the disciples in Acts and see how God uses them so mightily, and I desire to be used like that, but yet I lack the faith to trust that God will do it. I had a really good friend recently. We went and got coffee, and I was explaining how I've been working long hours and working late and working extra, and yet I'm still somehow behind, and I just don't get it. I just don't get it. How am I still behind, yet I work 60 hours a week? And they said, Cameron, it's because you're doing everything in your own strength instead of relying on the Lord's. Now, secret, at that point, I told him, the meeting's over. I don't want to talk to you. Please leave, because it wrecked me. It was so convicting. You see, I didn't have the faith to trust that God was going to do the work. And that's a really sad, sad place to be. I want to be used by the Lord, but I've allowed busyness and a lack of faith to stop me from doing things that I feel like He's really called me to do, like this video right here, this YouTube channel that I'm starting. This is something that I've really felt God put on my heart for the last few months, yet I've lacked the faith to stop and allow Him to do the work. I've been contemplating how to start this YouTube channel and how to do this first video for a long time. But I've allowed fear, the worry that people are going to make fun of me, and ultimately a lack of faith in just trying to do it in my own power stop me. But last night, as I was really contemplating more about how I want God to do the work, I felt inspired. I felt like I had this full idea. I finally felt creative because I was allowing it to be God's work and not my own. Now, the reason I really felt like God was calling me to do stuff on the internet, to do YouTube, to do these videos, is because I feel like we as a church, the global church, Big C, have left this area untouched. I work in student ministry, and so often I hear different students of mine talk about their favorite YouTuber or their favorite content creator, and so I go and watch their videos because I want to stay relevant. And so often their messages are not messages of hope. They're not messages of these kids' identity being rooted in the gospel and who Jesus is. Their messages are things that are fleeting. Their messages are things that are robbing people, young people, of the hope that they can have in Jesus Christ. And yet we as a collective church, Big C, are not taking the steps we need to bring God back to culture. We've allowed ourselves to be completely kind of disconnected from culture, and so we've lost our place. We've lost our ability to create culture, because for thousands of years, the church was the epicenter of culture. It was the epicenter of science and art, and yet somehow we've allowed ourselves to lose that. We've lost it. There's this really amazing guy named Alex Dion Wilson, and I'm gonna link his channel right up here. And this guy I got to talk on the phone with, and he is really kind of the pioneer behind the hashtag Bring God Back to Culture. And as I was talking to him, I really heard his message and his heart for online ministry, and it really inspired me. His heart is just to be a dominant force in YouTube and the internet and stop allowing ourselves to lose footing to the world. And here's the thing about Alex. He doesn't have this multi-million dollar production company. He doesn't have red cameras and the craziest gear. He's just a guy with the right heart, with the faith knowing that God can work, and the humility to be used by the Lord. And I want to do that with him. I want to partner with him in the ministry of YouTube and the internet. And so that's why I'm here. I want to bring God back to culture. I want to bring God back to YouTube and the internet and social media. I want to be a dominant force in online ministry, because I believe and I have faith that God will do the work. We just need to be humble tools in his hand. I desire to bring a message of hope. I desire to bring a message of truth. I desire to bring the message of your identity being rooted solely in the fact that you are adopted, that you are chosen, and that you are bought with a price. That the blood of Jesus Christ is what defines us. Not our money, not our status, not what we have, the things we wear, not the things that even happen to us, or sometimes even the decisions we've made. But it's only Jesus that defines us. So I'm here on YouTube now. I'm here to share my experiences. I'm here to share my stories. I'm here to share my failures. I'm here to share my shortcomings. But I'm also here to share my victories and my growth and my life with you. I am here to bring God back to culture. So excuse me while I take a few minutes to do what I said earlier, which is to come to this spot, my spot, and put pen to paper, to clear my head, to jot down ideas, to seek the Lord and the work that he wants to do, the plan that he has, so I can walk more in him and less in me. So give me just a little bit. So that's it. That's the journey we're going on. I've jotted down some ideas for the future, and I want you guys to be with me. So subscribe, comment down below with maybe some ideas of things that you would want to talk about, and let's bring God back to culture together.